going to drive those cars on the highway, guess what? You're going to need gasoline, and to buy that gasoline, you're going to need money, and that's what we talk about here. Next up, our Newsmax Director of Financial Newsletters, Jeff Yastine, joins us. The Money Master is in the house. All right, Jeff, let's go ahead and get to Wall Street. Looks like a pretty good day.
It does. The Dow's up about 150 points. It was as high as 220 earlier in the day. We have the S&P 500 up about 28 points, NASDAQ up 75. I think we're going to talk about it in a second, but there was some really good economic data that came out, and that's put Wall Street in a buying mood, a more confident mood compared to yesterday's bit of a wipeout session.
I saw a picture that a friend sent me the other day on social media, actually yesterday. It was a gas pump, and it said $1.99 per gallon, which I didn't think any of us would ever see again. Now today comes news that a barrel of crude oil has fallen below $60 for the first time since 2009. Yippee!
It is, you know, it's amazing to think about, but then again, oil is a commodity, supply and demand. You can go onto a government website, the U.S. Energy Information Administration. They track how much oil is coming out of the field, weekly field production. And if you look at that week by week, month by month, the U.S. keeps adding more and more production thus far. It's like 1,000 more barrels per week compared to a month earlier, et cetera, et cetera. So as long as that amount of supply continues to build and the economy moves in the direction it has without much support from Europe and China, I think we may continue, as some have speculated, to see oil prices move yet lower. I saw one estimate from a serious firm the other day that predicted $30 a barrel oil, so half of what we are today, which is already down 40 or 50% from 3, 4, or 5 months ago.
I'm going to go right back out and look for a 440 1969 Dodge Charger to go ahead and suck up as much gasoline as I possibly can.
With a four-barrel carburetor,
no air cleaner on it whatsoever, dual exhaust. I want to go out there and blow off as much oil as I possibly can
while I can.
Why not? All right, old school guys, man, they're still the best cars. Here's some good economic news you were talking about. Retail sales beat the expectations in November, increasing 0.6% after rising 0.5% in October. Simply put, good news.
It is. And what economists have gleaned from the aggregate of that data is that consumers really are, in the money that they're saving by not spending as much on gasoline, they really are taking that savings and going out and spending it elsewhere in the economy. That's what the Fed certainly wants to see. And that's what the markets like to hear, hence today's rally.
Definitely. All right, and if you do ever take mileage off your car, here's another piece of good news. The IRS is going to go. They used to pay 56 cents a mile now that you could take off on your taxes. Now, as of January 1st, 57.5 cents per mile. For the people who really use their vehicles and travel a lot of mileage, that adds up to a lot of dollars over a year.
It does. So, again, another little bit of help, especially with our economy being based so much on freelance and other efforts in which people have to fill out those expense forms, et cetera. It's just more good news for the economy. The big question mark is how much of this is already factored in by the stock market months ago. That's the thing that nobody really can answer until we get into next year.
All right. Burger King is saving millions in U.S. taxes in their inversion with their pending buyout of a Canadian coffee and donuts chain, Tim Horton. What a shock. I never thought they'd be looking to save tax dollars.
Yeah, this is from a study done by Americans for Tax Fairness, obviously wrapping this particular move by Burger King. You and I have talked about it off and on for the last number of months. They want to buy or have bought basically Tim Hortons. They want to move their headquarters to Canada. And Americans for Tax Fairness say that the combined company, will save about $117 million in corporate income taxes the first year, since they'll be based in Canada, and perhaps as much as $275 million in the following 3 years after that deal. Burger King says that this is based on the report itself is materially flawed, but they haven't necessarily hit the particular points as to where those mistakes or misinterpretations are. Granted, like you say, Burger King is going to save some tax money here.
They're going to save some money. The report is flawed. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink, say no more. Here we go. And we're still not going to drop the price of a hamburger or a cheeseburger, no matter what you think.
All right, Jeff.
Want to remind everybody that if folks want to find out what's happening, money news 24/7 around the world, go to newsmax.com. Click on money. You'll find money news right there. Jeff Yastine and the entire team will be there to keep you updated as to what's going on. Jeff, always a pleasure, my friend. Have a great day, and we will talk to you again real soon.
Thanks, Ed.
All right, buddy. Sheriff Mack is in the nation's capital. Lawmakers need take heed as he and fellow members of law enforcement are demanding to be heard on immigration. He'll join us after the break. We question everything right here on Midpoint.